Hello everyone, this video has been a long while in the making and it's mostly down to my fault. I just haven't got around to doing it. So we're trying to get it done today, so let's see if we can get it done. Quite simply, it's how I set up my Wavelink system to work with OBS and where I'm using and not using certain parts of it to be able to add features to my audio, like noise gates and everything else in OBS, which you cannot do, I'd say as it stands, in Wavelink. First, we're going to jump into Wavelink and show you what I've done in Wavelink and which parts of it I use and which I don't. And then we'll jump over to OBS and show you how to set up the filters and the way I have my mic set up in OBS. So this is quite straightforward, and I found personally this is the best way for me to have it set up because I have a lot more control over my microphone in OBS as well as using Wavelink. And you can add filters and other things you cannot do in Wavelink at the moment. So now we're into the Wavelink software itself. You'll see first off that my mic itself is muted off here. I don't use my microphone through the Wavelink software itself, and the reason for that, it will become clear shortly. The system sounds is pretty much all my game audio. Everything from the system still comes through the system sounds. I've left that as it is. I just found it was easier to leave the game coming through the system sounds. The music side of things is set up on my Windows Media Player. I have all my tracks in Windows Media Player. I have it set to the same audio level as the stream so I can hear exactly what you're hearing, because personally I feel music should be more of a background thing than a main thing, and you have the game audio as your main. So I like to make sure the levels are good. I have the game level slightly higher in my ears than on stream, but it gives me a good idea of what the levels are all like. Now we're onto the voice chat, and the voice chat is my Discord or whichever voice chat system you're using. I've got them all set up in there, so I use Zoom for certain things for work. Now the voice chat is good, so you can mute it off stream as well. So if you wanted to have someone in chat but they don't want to be on stream, or you don't want to have other people on stream but you want to hear what they're saying, you can put them in there and then mute it off. So the effects one I have set up here is for OBS. So all my OBS audio, all my alerts, everything from OBS comes through the effects tab. Now, that's a good thing because you have more control over the audio levels of your alerts for your stream and yourself. I have them slightly higher for myself in the stream because I have quite loud alerts sometimes. So that's just handy to have that extra option. So these last three are kind of optional. I have my Firefox and my internet browsers all coming through the browser source one, which I keep muted off stream. So if anyone sends me a video and I want to watch it, I can watch it. Or if I need to look something up whilst I'm streaming, I can go onto YouTube, find the video, play it. They can't hear it, I can. And then we're all good, right? Simples. Now the game one as well, I don't use it for game. I use it occasionally for some games, but that's just there for the odd game that I do use it on. And then AUX one is used for everything else. And it's just a spare. I've got it set up for my VLC media player because that was really loud at one point. So I use that as a second audio option to turn it down. That's the Wavelink part of this video done. So now we're gonna head over to OBS and we'll show you how we have it set up in OBS. And you'll see why I've done a few things here when we head over there. So let's go over to OBS and go through that part. So welcome to OBS. Now we're in OBS. I'll show you what you need to do. Now, the first thing we need to go to the settings. So first off, we click on the settings button here, and then you'll see the settings box appear. And then what you need to do, you need to go to audio, and then you have your mic auxiliary. You set that up as your Wavelink stream. Okay, so that's all your audio coming through from the Wavelink. Obviously, as you're aware, the mic is muted out. Secondly, mic auxiliary audio 2. If you set that to mic in Elgato Wave 3, that'll bring your mic in separately into OBS. So now what you'll see, we've got the desktop audio coming through and then my microphone coming through, and you can obviously see the bar there working there. Now, if we would play some music, obviously you'll see the desktop audio work. But that basically gives you the mic set up separately. You just adjust the audio levels in here, as you can see I've done here, so it's not peaking. But again, you still have the clip guard feature, okay? Then what you can do, you can click on the cog, go to filters, then you'll get this screen pop up. See, now what you can do, you can put on noise gate, you can put on a compression, an EQ. I've got a bunch of other filters here as well, which does a few other things. But we'll go through them in another video. Now, the noise gate, compression, and EQ can all be found in the video up in one of the top corners somewhere up there. We'll share that one. That one was done one we done quickly, but we are going to go through and how to do it properly. This was just how I've got it set up so you guys can see. That's pretty much it for the OBS. So that's it. Simple, You have your mic separate in OBS, your Wavelink doing all your other audio. The great thing with that, as you saw, you can put filters on, such as noise gate compression and everything else. We'll go through the filters and the effects side of things in another video. If you have enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Also, I do stream over on Twitch, and you can find links all down below. Any comments, please put them also down below. So yeah, anyway, till next time, have fun. Bye bye.
Yeah. All right. 3, 2, 1, fire!